cows don't fly. Do you have any ideas? You won't believe me, I was asked this question at the final stage of one interview. You see, people tend to think within fixed frames of mind on a daily basis. So when they have exceptional situations, they're usually shocked or stressed out. Sometimes life may give you unanswerable questions or absurd puzzles like why cows don't fly. So I was asked this question at the final stage of ISEC program called Cultural Exchange. Let me reveal an important secret to you. The purpose of this question is not about testing a person's logic, but his or her reaction to uncommon cases. Now I realize how appropriate that question was, because the chain of non-standard situations started right after that. I chose to work in Malaysia at shelter, and my coordinator was untrustworthy. So I was not really sure about my trip, even 6 hours before my flight. My brain was exploding. I feel so grateful to my parents for allowing me to take that tough decision and take the risk to make that tough decision. So that time, that would be my first trip alone, and I had never left my home city, Almaty. So when I sat in a plane, I thought, what the heck am I doing? But it was too late. So I arrived. It was surprising for me to see palm trees in December. There was no snow around. Women of all ages wearing hijabs, riding motorcycles at high speed. I had an incredibly unusual New Year in Malaysia, with an Indian Santa Claus, wearing shorts, sunglasses, and singing a rap song. You see, I used to play with several kids. I used to play with kids before my trip, but I could only handle one at a time. So working with several children who do not speak your language was a totally different challenge. Let's remember, first trip alone, no one reliable, no idea what to expect. So there were times when the youngest ones took volunteers' hands to get help, play, or seek protection. When they took my hand, I felt so powerful and capable of resolving all of their issues. So once, when I was feeling as powerful as always, when the 3-year-old took my hand and asked me to take him to the toilet. So yes, these kids also can ground. After that, I was full of stereotypes before my trip. One of them, a human factor of those who study well is much higher than those who study not so well. My students were from 6 to 11 years old. I need to admit that I had the favorite one, since he was cute, thorough, and disciplined. In contrast, there was another boy, his peer, Kugan. He was so stubborn, careless, and very impatient. So once, I had to pick up the kids from school, and Kugan came first, and we started waiting for the rest. That day, I was terribly sad because of the sick child back at the shelter. Kugan noticed my mood and asked, "What happened, Teacher Aisha?" I replied, "No worries, I'm fine. Please tell me, how can I help you?" I could really say that he really wanted to help me, and I was deeply touched. It was very surprising for me to find out that he was more upset about me leaving Malaysia than my favorite kid. There were so many occasions in Malaysia that pulled me completely out of my comfort zone. They turned me into someone who is more loyal, open-minded, a little more brave. My values changed. You see, I have worked with orphans who had no one to turn to call to when they needed protection. So I started appreciating more the fact that I have my parents to turn to in this big and wild world. Then I learned that it is very important to give an equal amount of love, especially to kids. Sometimes life gives you challenges, sometimes it throws you into the harsh reality, and sometimes later the answer comes. And hey, do you want to know my answer to why cows don't fly? Well, part of it was that everything in life has its own purpose.
Yes, Aisha says nothing happens by accident. Everything has a reason. There's a reason you're here tonight, and we hope that some of these speeches will touch your heart. Because I know it did mine. As you talk about the orphanages, just this week, as we were, my wife and I were riding our bikes, we happened upon some orphans from Bagana Shiel, where we've done a summer camp. And a little boy, Vitya, who is one of my favorites, came up and just gave us the biggest hug. When you give back to kids like that, it does so much for your life. So thanks for sharing that with us.